say I go, okay, and then I go in here. Okay, touching. So stage three is a street port, so I use this port diameter for my stage threes, and then my stage five is fully opened up. So it's hard to see it, but knowing what you remove, like I know that this one is significantly bigger than the other, probably by a quarter inch.
What's going on, you guys? Charlie and Dalen here, bringing you another episode of MAPtv. Today, we're talking all about porting. We got Aric in there right now doing some work, and honestly, we probably can't go in there because you require like a mask and all that kind of stuff.
There's it's really stuff. Loud.
Yeah, and it's super loud.
Really loud.
So, I mean, anyways, I know we're both super happy to be showing this process.
Yeah, I mean, this is something that I think is, I don't think a lot of people know us for porting work. I don't think it's understood how much effort and work is put into a head.
Right.
I know that, you know, when the sales guys are talking with people on the phone about a head, it's like, oh, well, just, you know, chuck it up, take some drill bits, take some porting bits, and we're good to go. When in reality, we have upwards of 40, 50 hours in the head sometimes with a single person working on them. So kind of get an idea of what you're paying for and why we feel we have that value in our program.
And not only that, but also to explain what the value is in having a ported head in general too. I mean, I know a lot
I'm just assuming that everybody knows that.
But some people genuinely don't know the benefit of having a ported head. And so today, you guys are gonna learn all about that. We're probably not gonna be as involved during the process because, as he said, it takes a long time.
And it's a very small room.
Yeah. It's a lot of people to be in one small room. So.
Yeah, no, I think that Aric does a great job of explaining this stuff. He's been doing this for a long time. He's very smart, very meticulous. I'm really glad that we're gonna get him on camera with this.
For sure. Well, there you guys have it. We'll probably jump in with Aric now.
The old pride and glory right here.
Cylinder head porting is the process of material removal for better potential flow of a cylinder head. So a stock port like this, we cut these up so I can see how far I can go, where there's coolant, where I need to look out for. So the top and the bottom has coolant that runs through it like so. And then you can see this line is the factory gasket, where the gasket comes out to. If we're looking at side-by-side comparisons, where the gasket comes out to, you can see how much material is removed from a fully ported 1,000 horsepower cylinder head versus a bone stock one. So there's a lot of material removed. There's a lot of guide shaping that happens. And then also the transition from right here out. And then same with the intake side. You can see how much material you have to work with. This one is what we call like a stage five 4G63 head prep. So this one's seen a lot of extensive porting and reshaping. MAP offers three different options. So there's a pocket porting, which is just done from this from the guide transition up into the seat area. So that's what our pocket porting option is. And then we have a stage three, which is what I'm going to be working on today, which is a mild port job. So light reshaping and then a full polish on the intake and exhaust side. And then we have a stage five, which is our race port, which is a oversized porting job, combustion chamber, deshrouding and polishing, and then oversized intake reshaping. Porting a cylinder head will do a few things. So it'll increase the cylinder head's potential to perform at a higher RPM. So if you have a stock port, 30 pounds of boost, you kind of peek out, like the head can only flow so much. So the goal with porting is to make it flow more without sacrificing volumetric efficiency. Because if you port something too big, eventually you're gonna find the smallest point and that's your bottleneck. So having some, like having a huge inlet doesn't always get you what you want versus like having something that's paired really well for the intake and exhaust side. So if I can add more airflow in, I can add more fuel, I can make more power. Just need to make sure that I can get the gas out fast enough. When I'm staring down a port, I want this to be as straight of a shot with a slight bottleneck in to build velocity versus something that is just huge and bottlenecks down. So I want it to be as straight with a slight bottleneck, not too much, not too little. Now there's some other things like this, the guide bosses and stuff. Those are things that I'll be removing. Those are restrictions that don't need to be there. You know, most of the time when people are building Evos, they want it to perform better than it did before. You can get away with that a few ways. You could put bigger cams in, which will keep the valve open longer, more airflow, more combustion, more exhaust gas. You can do a bigger valve, which is more air, volumetric efficiency, combustion, etc. You can do all three and really optimize it, where you can put bigger cams, bigger valves, a bigger port. Those three things will introduce three times as much air as what a stock head can do. Because if I port a head, but I'm putting stock cams back on it, I'm probably gonna see losses because the cam is only opening so much and the airflow isn't moving fast enough to make a difference. So for a stage three head, which is our mild street port, we're not really gonna be oversizing, mainly just reshaping. And the valve job that comes after this will help deliver airflow faster into the combustion chamber. These are just the tools that I use for my job. So I have ones like this, which are really aggressive. They remove material very fast. I treat these like end mills. So I try to just do straight cuts with them versus a lot of back and forth movement. And then I have ones like these, which is more of a medium cut. And then I have a really fine one that I can get pretty much all the way through the port in. So this is a nice detailer one for going in and smoothing out rougher cuts. And then from there, after the head's been all rough cut, I have multiple different length and multiple different style cartridge rolls that I use for the polishing portion. The more aggressive, the less control you have, because it can get violent. Like if you don't have good grip, if you don't have good posture, because you're gonna be going at it for a long time. This isn't a 20 minute job. Something like this takes 8 to 10 hours. But to start, for a stage three head, we're not gonna be doing the full port. I'm just gonna be doing some reshaping and then we're gonna go back in and polish it out. Same with the exhaust side. For the intake side, it's mainly you remove the restrictions and then you polish it and then you validate it. We're gonna start with, I'll remove all of these guide bosses and the casting flash. And then I'll go back in with my detailer, clean it up a little bit and then see if I need to go more or less. And then once I get to a point, we'll be switching over to the cartridge roll for the polishing portion.
So we port heads by hand. But there's companies that offer CNC porting programs And then they even offer like a hand finishing where they go through and polish it after it's imported. The reason that we don't do that on Mitsubishi heads is it's called core shift. So like the next set at port probably won't be identical to this one because every head has slight casting differences. So it's something you gotta keep in mind, like generally when you put the gasket on it to see where it's at, like the 4D63 head.
Mm-hmm.
It's not something I'd recommend CNC porting, mainly because each port is slightly in a slightly different location than what it's supposed to be. So generally cylinder one will be perfect, and then generally the casting is shifted ever so slightly. So Evo 10s are a lot better, but yeah, the CNC porting, I mean, there's massive gains to be made there, you know, like quality control, you know, you can make sure that it's ported the exact same way every time. Sometimes with CNC porting though, you won't even touch in some areas because the casting is low from what their program is written for. So hand porting, I can go through and I can adjust that on the fly and make sure that everything is to how I want it to be. Versus a CNC porting program that like, if you send your head to a company to get CNC ported, they're gonna toss it in their machine and they're gonna run it and then they're gonna box it up and send it to you. Hand porting and hand finishing, I can make them all look the same and all be the same size without having to rely on a CNC to do it. Granted, CNC porting goes a lot faster, but in the grand scheme of things, I want to make sure that the product that customer receives is uniform all around and will perform the same on every port. If this is my stock port, going from a stock port, the next one over is my stage 5 port, which has knife edging done and then gasket matching, and then it's set up for oversized valves. And then if you go to the next one, this is just a reshaped runner for my stage 3 port standard valve. You know, I have one head of everything that I port and then one variant of every port program that we offer. So like if when I want to go through and check something, like what's the diameter of this, I'll do that. And then I'll take this and I'll match it to the heads that I'm porting, just for a good double check.
Let's just say I go, okay, and then I go in here. Okay, touching. So stage 3 is a street port. So I use this port diameter for my stage 3s. And then my stage 5 is fully opened up.
There's different stages. Each, the 5 takes the longest. And that's kind of like the race port. Generally I run like a S2 or S3 GSC powertrain components for a stage 5, you know, like with a +1 valve pairing it and a really stiff spring. And then stage 3s, I will run a milder spring, and then S1 or S2 cams or stock cams, because like I said, I'm not actually changing the runner volume, I'm just reshaping it.
So everything is opened up.
Like if you were to reach out to us to get a cylinder head built and you're like, I don't really know what I need, you should go with the stage 3. If you call me and be like, I'm gonna throw the kitchen sink down the drag strip, stage 5 might be an option. But knowing that the stage 3 is kind of like the perfect port for any street strip daily driving car, and that's for all of our offerings. We do the same process for the Evo 89 and the Subaru. Generally, you'll see about like a 10 to 12% gain on a stage 3 Evo 10 head versus like potentially upwards of 20 in the higher RPM on a stage 5. So it's really about if you are only revving to 7,000 RPM, you know, pretty conservative for Evo. Is a stage five necessary? No, because a stage five only shines in the higher RPM. So I would say that it's hard to determine how much horsepower you would pick up. It's more based off how many CFM increases as the valve opens.
All right, you guys, so there you have it. Hopefully at this point, if you didn't have an understanding of what porting is or some of the process, maybe now you hopefully understand it a little bit more. I mean, I'm sure you can recap a little bit for them. I don't want to say it in a too stupid of a version.
I'll try to be as simple as possible because it could go on for hours. Yeah. But I mean, the idea behind porting a head is that depending on the current modifications, camshafts, how much air you want to remove from the engine, you're going to find limits of how much air you can get in. And so you're going to have to make decisions on how high you're revving the motor. You know, if the car's stock rev limit, a much smaller port is usually much more beneficial. It's one of those things where there's so many complexities to it, and we've spent so many years developing what we have that it's really cool to show people, because there's so many intricate decisions that go into how we do it and why we do it that will affect how your engine runs and how it makes power. It's just such a it's such a neat process that it's cool to show people. It's such a complex process that doesn't really get the it doesn't get the love that it deserves. It, like, this is one of the most beneficial things you can do to a built engine.
Absolutely. Well, anyways, guys, that's gonna wrap it up for today's video. If you guys are interested in seeing more content just like this, make sure that you subscribe to our channel, because we're putting out content like this at least every week. So nonetheless, otherwise, leave us a comment down below. If you have questions about porting, you wanna see more content around porting, maybe a further video in greater detail on a specific part, we'll definitely go ahead and listen to that. And if you haven't noticed, we do make sure that we reply to every single comment down below in the first 24 hours. So if this is a video you watch and you want to let us know your thoughts, make sure to do that in the first 24 hours, because that's when we're checking. Otherwise, leave us a big thumbs up, because it does make a big difference for our channel. It helps the videos get seen and helps us out in the long run. So nonetheless, that's going to end it for today, guys.
And if anyone wants a half hour long video of me eating curly fries, please also leave that in the comments. Arby's, I'll take free curly fries. Or heavily discounted curly fries. People are laughing because they think this is a joke, but I'm dead serious. More curly fries.
We'll see you next time. Peace.